Yeah, I agree with you, Roflo. You heard me saying that rip right there leading in, that kind of everything morphs into one. I faced him in some sim games on some backfields. I faced him when I was with the Nats, and he is a problem. He doesn't even need big time velocity, but obviously if he adds a little bit more like he's done, it certainly helps.
You know, he dropped about 3 miles an hour. You drop like that, I don't care who you are. Now, you know this man has the heart of a lion, you know, so you don't have to ever worry about the competitive level. Now, I'm looking at this. You were praising Eric Nays before. If I get a team, you're my manager, because I know we can have a glass of wine and
yes,
talk about
can.
The game. And Eric Nays, I'm poaching him for the analytics staff. But when you look at Bumgarner when he was in San Francisco, always has been a tough at bat, because what? You've never seen anyone like this guy. The guy that gives you the wingspan, you see the full number 40, and then he got over to Arizona, a big contract. You see the drop in fastball, cutter, and curveball velocity. Almost impossible to make that transformation that quickly when you first get with a team. Those were his first 12 starts. Now listen, a lot of those pitches are in the middle of the plate. You can't make any argument against that.
Yeah.
I mean, that is middle, and missing his spots, and it doesn't matter if you're throwing 88 or 98 if it's down the middle to big league hitters. But what he's done his last four starts, he's got that velocity up on his cutter, on his curveball, on his fastball, 3 more miles an hour. He's hitting the spots that are all around the strike zone. He's able to, when he gets ahead in the count, bury hitters by throwing the ball out of the strike zone. He's always been uber aggressive, uber competitive, and now he's being uber intelligent, as you can see what the numbers are. 4 for 47 off his curve and cutter in his last four starts. He's back. And Arizona needs him to be back.
Look at this.
Yes. Opponents average the first one. It's almost like, to me,
I know batting average is thrown out.
Yeah.
I used to look at it. Like, if I'm facing Ron Darling and I see the league's hitting 180 off you, you're doing something right.
That's right.
If I see a good ERA, but the league's hitting 275, I'm like, all right, I'm going to get some.
Do you think there's a hangover for a guy who was as great as he was in San Francisco, signs a big contract, and now he's in a new place?
Yeah, I
you know
think so.
Where you don't, you know, they're not looking at him like San Francisco reveres him. He's got to earn his place or earn some of his place, and now he's earning it now.
Yeah, I think there's a comfortability factor that he had with San Francisco, that he kind of walked in the clubhouse and the seas parted, because Mad Bum was walking through and what he had meant. Maybe not the same in Arizona when he first got there.
That's right.
And then he doesn't pitch well out of the chute.
That's right.
So it ate at him. But you see a guy who's letting it go. He's ripping that cutter inside.
Well, he's feeling confident again. He's got that little bit of uptick, which is enough for him to get by.
Yeah. So.